Before I do this next one, there's this group that have kind of split it up from the BNP, and they're claiming that they have nothing to do with them, called the EDL, the English Defence League, and they're planning on holding an anti-Muslim protest at a mosque in Harrow, and they basically, these people are known to get violent, they're known to just be thugs, they're recruiting off the football terraces now, and so, you know, basically we need people down at the mosque in Harrow to defend it tomorrow morning. If you go on the Unite Against Fascism site, you'll see some details there, but you know, be careful and all that. But I suffer quite badly from insomnia, and last night it kind of has its plus size because I wrote this, but I'm going to read it off a bit of paper because I wrote it last night. The walls have ears, a mouth and eyes. Sometimes it keeps them closed and sometimes it lies. For some it frowns, for some it smiles. For some, it's a blatant witch trial. But as soon as there's another dragon to slay, it's the ritual benefit and the poor who'll pay. And through the slog of time, your intention becomes clear. When it's profit, you keep it. When it's debt, we share. While fear is at the opposite end of the spectrum to love, we point our fingers to the sides instead of above. And before we know it, we're disconnected from each other. We've locked our doors and pulled down our shutters. And it seems the only ones who can save us are the ones who put us here. And round and round and round we go in this cycle of fear. Well, if I had the power to take them all down, I'd do every one of them, from Walpole to Brown. I don't care who got the highest rating at the last poll. History's taught me it's always the same shit, different arsehole. The elite make our choices because we're just poor fools. We can't think for ourselves or even use our tools. We just demand more magazines, white t-shirts, black shoes, blue jeans, tits and arse and arse and tits and stuff and things and bobs and bits. And pretty soon I realized none of that satisfied me. And the docile, happy state I was in was what tired me. So I looked for a banner I could march behind. But I couldn't find the one that said, be whoever you like. The right were clearly wrong and out of tune with humanity. Didn't seem to comprehend the value of mortality. The left was splitting and nitpicking like it was a treasure hunt. Like the People's Front of Judea and the Judean People's Front. I didn't sign my name, but I snatched their megaphone. I took to the streets and I marched on my own. The cameras zoomed in and the helicopters hovered. They turned up with their weapons out and their numbers covered. I felt the shadow of Menezes, of Tomlinson, of Peach. I heard their final cries echo in the breeze as the baton rained blow after blow after blow across my face. I spat through my gritted teeth, you'll never take this place. He shouted, Warburg, Bernay, Adam Smith, Zolik, Rockefeller. I replied, Guthrie, Goldman, Bakunin, George Carlin, Zapata. Our words left our mouths and fought there in the street, but the number of myself alone couldn't compare with the beat. So tonight the batons and bullets outweighed the sticks and stones. But for every one of them, there's 50 of us marching on our own. We can't be kept apart forever. And when we do come together, it will be only natural for the mob to overthrow the oppressor. We'll organize the homeless and organize the gangs, then take a bulldozer to the walls of the banks. You never second guess on an army of rats. We live in the cracks of the system, but ICE will expand. And we've seen no justice, so there will be no peace. It's love and rage that will fuel this stampede. So I'll take my places in the trenches with some petrol and a match. All I need for this cocktail is a bottle and a match. And if in our ranks we've got 2 million men, let us not march them to the top of the hill and then back down again. Change doesn't come from Babylon with chanting poems and songs. Change comes from Babylon when we demand they right their wrongs. When we unite as one, we're strong. We're strong when we unite as wrong. Peaceful protest has its place, but now we're 5 years on. That's 5 years of torture, corporate takeovers and bombs. The time is now or never to finally take action. Remember, these streets are our streets. It's us who built this town. We built up this city, and we can tear it